Welcome to the Merch Minds podcast, where we discuss everything about the Merch by Amazon business and the print-on-demand industry. Here are your hosts, Glen and Yong.
Welcome, everybody, to the very first episode of Merch Minds, the podcast where we're going to be talking about Merch by Amazon. And with me, I have the man, the myth, the legend, Yong.
Hey, what's going on? You know, that's a pretty nice introduction, man. Thank you so much. But yeah, you know, this is our very first episode. You know, I'm really excited about this whole new venture, about talking about the whole print-on-demand industry. So let's get with it, man. What are we going to talk about here?
And you know what? Man, the myth, the legend, do not use that on a shirt. It's trademarked Yong. Sorry about that. Just kidding.
Is it really? wait. So you're telling me the man, the myth, the legend, Yong is trademark?
Oh, Yong, exactly. The very trademark. Yeah, we can't use that. So
okay.
Tell everybody a little bit about yourself, Yong. Like maybe a little bit about your background as far as like graphic design, and maybe a little bit about merch and what got you excited about merch in general.
Yeah. Well. So my story is, first of all, you and I have been discussing this whole podcast since this past December.
I know. And then we talked about it more.
Yeah. So we definitely got to let the people know, we didn't just get on here and just, you know, decide to do a podcast. No, this has been in the works since this past December. And the only reason that I bring that up is because, I had met up with you in El Paso and, you had asked me, you're like, hey man, are you doing Merch by Amazon yet? And my response was no, because late last year, you know, I had a lot of things going on in my life. You know, I was in the middle of a move. You know, I had a couple of friends, you know, that were very close to me had passed away, and you know, just other issues in my life. And plus, you know, I was in the middle of, you know, we were in the middle of Q4, which is, you know,
exactly,
the most profitable and, you know,
time of the year.
Yeah, time of the year for people who are reselling. So I hadn't even touched Merch by Amazon, but I remember having a conversation with you and you're like, dude, if you're not doing merch right now, you need to get on board. So I was like, sure. So long story short, fast forward to about 2-3 weeks. By the time I got back home, I signed up for merch, but unfortunately, they had put a hold on approving people's accounts.
That's right.
So I had put my application in, but I didn't get in until like 3 months later. So So about 2-3 months later, I finally got in, but then I got hit with another restriction, right? Now they have put a hold on tiering people up to the next level. So I was stuck at 25 shirts, but what I was doing was I was constantly rotating the shirts out. So for instance, if I had a design that was selling relatively well, I would just leave it on there, but then, you know, shirts that wouldn't sell, after 2 weeks, I would pull them, and then I would put up a new shirt. And then finally, after like another 2 more months, I got tiered to 50. No, is it 50? It's 100, right? It's
100.
Yeah, it's 100. And then I finally got tiered to 500 a couple of weeks ago. But that's pretty much how I got started doing merch. Now, as far as my background, I've been doing graphic design for a pretty long time. Granted, I didn't formally get an education in graphic design up until about a few years ago. In case you guys don't know my story, I did go back to college, and I got my degree in graphic design at San Jose State University. But I've been doing it for a long time, so don't let that confuse you. So with that background and knowledge, doing merch by Amazon is not, I wouldn't say it's easy, but it's something that I'm very passionate about. And you know, you and I discussed this, Glen. I mean, the hard part really for me is just coming up with a concept. And once I can come up with a concept, I can typically have a design ready within 30 minutes or less.
Yeah. And you know what, like 2-3 months seems to be kind of like the going rate for people, to wait to get accepted. 'Cause You know, it's really about being patient, and that just goes with everything that you're doing as far as business goes. And so usually 2 or 3 months, at least is what I've heard and people that I've talked to, is usually how long it takes to get accepted into the, you know, Merch by Amazon platform. But it's very interesting to hear your story, because I know we talked about it for a good while, and you're like, you know what, I know I'm going to get tiered up to 500, and you're telling me like it's coming soon. And a lot of people have also found that, you know, hey, I surpassed 25 sales. When do I tier up to the next one? And it just goes the same thing. It's about being patient and just keep grinding these designs and listing and keep, you know, hustling when it comes to merch, because it will happen. And it's just an awesome opportunity, you know, to make money without putting any money in, really.
Right. Exactly. I mean, you do the work up front, and then you benefit from it afterwards. Again, some shirts will sell better than others, but I mean, it's like writing a book, right? Some books sell better than others. That's pretty much my story, man. I mean, it took a while, but it sounds like Amazon is finally catching up. You know, they're approving accounts, they're tiering people up. So it's just a matter of time, man, before I catch up to you, man. Just a matter of time. And I know you're putting up some big numbers, man. So what's your story? I think everyone pretty much knows your story by now, but in case they don't, let us know your story. And again, I mean, Glen is putting up some ridiculous numbers.
Well, as far as like my background goes, I graduated from the University of Texas at El Paso in 2009 with a Bachelor of Arts degree, and then my major was in graphic design. And, you know, I had been reselling and doing all that. And once this opportunity came up of Merch by Amazon, I was just kind of blown away by, you know, like this opportunity just seemed really, really rare. Like it didn't even seem real at first. I was like, it doesn't cost anything per month. You don't have to pay anything. You don't have to, you know, it just seemed just like a crazy opportunity that I knew I had to get in. But like Yong said, it was around that fourth quarter time that that's when it first started. I think it was around August or September is when they opened it up. And I signed up in November, but I really didn't start putting any designs until the middle of December, when kind of like that Q4 time, you kind of already know that things are going to be slowing down a little bit more since, you know, Christmas is coming up and everything like that. So I didn't put anything up yet until that time. And then I just started, you know, messing around with some designs. I was the same thing that Yong said, you know, 25 designs at first. And really, it was just kind of like trial and error. I mean, I remember just going back to like my old shirts, and I was like, man, I didn't have any keywords on here. I didn't have like, you know, but during that time, there also wasn't, you know, as many designs as there are now, of course. But I just kept, you know, plugging in shirts and just growing it from there. So, of course, the tier up went to 100, and then the 500 and 1,000 kept going like that. So right now, I am at 8,000 is my tier right now.
Wow.
And I have about like 2,500 designs right now on merch.
Man, you're killing it, man. You're killing it. Like I said, I mean, you obviously got a head start ahead of me, man, but it's just a matter of time before I catch up to you. And I guarantee I will catch up to you, man. My man.
Hey, that's what I like to hear. Cause you know what? Straight up, if you don't have that like drive and passion and mentality to think that you're going to outdo somebody, then really you're just going to stay the same. You're not really going to grow. I like that Yong is right here telling me in my face that he's going to do better than me, because that also helps me, you know, hustle even harder, grind even harder to get these designs out and push harder. So I think that's definitely the mindset that you have to have.
Yeah, well, this is obviously just a friendly little competition between you and I. You know, but it's, guys, I'm telling you, the opportunity is not only good, but it's just, it's so easy. And again, you know, it's not fair for me to say that it's easy, considering that Glen and I both come from a design background. But even if you don't, I mean, you can hire designers out there, whether it's on Upwork or Fiverr, and I'm sure there's a bunch of other sites out there where you can hire designers. You know, and you know, we've said this in the past, the designs, they don't have to be all elaborate, man. I mean, some of my best sellers are just text-based. And Glen, I showed you my my shirts in the Austin Greenwood meetup, and they're basic designs.
Exactly.
You know, you don't.
That's what we want to cover in this podcast for sure. Just some of like the design tactics, and you know, I think simpler. I mean, simple is better. I think that there's no reason to go crazy on certain designs. Uh-huh. But you know, I saw your shirts and I was like, some of them are really, really creative. I got to tell you that one. a lot of creativity, a lot of like, you know, funny stuff that I was like, man, never would have thought about that.
Yeah. But I was definitely on the whole political presidential debate mm-hmm. bandwagon there for a while, but it's still going on as we speak, but I'm kind of shying away from that these days, only because you know, it is going to come to an end at mm-hmm. the end of the year, and I need to design stuff that I can sell you know, today and you know, exactly. Next year, 5 years from now, and so that's what I've been focusing more on. But yeah, I mean, again, basic designs. Okay, you guys don't have to create like those crazy tap out affliction shirts, right? I mean they're nice to look at, but first of all, I'm sure if you do hire someone, it's going to cost you more money. But at the end of the day, why invest all that time and money, and then there's that possibility of that shirt not even selling?
Yeah. Exactly.
So, I mean, that's a huge risk. So I say start with basic designs, you know, basic graphics, basic text.
And I know you talked a little bit about, like a little bit about 500 is what your tier is right now. How many designs do you have live right now?
I currently have 171.
Oh, nice.
And as far as money, I've been doing about anywhere between $200 to $300 a month.
Okay, nice. And that's and a little bit of more, I guess a little bit, can you talk a little bit about how many designs per day or per week are you trying to get out? What are your sure. goals when it comes down to that?
Yeah. So as some of you guys may know, you know, I do have a day job, and then I you know, I do the whole hustling thing on the side, and then, you know, I do have a bunch of other contract jobs that I do on the side. So with all that said, I can only do about 3 shirts a day. Sometimes more, sometimes less. Last week, Glen, I took a page out of your book, man. I spent the whole day doing about 60 shirts. I know you had told me one day you did about 100. I spent the whole day and I did 60. So that's how I was able to get, 171 shirts currently, but
I think that's what's cool is like, you know, once you tear up, you have a little bit more like wiggle room, some playroom to mm-hmm. kind of see what works. Because I know when you're at first at 25, yeah, I mean, you kind of really have to be picky on what shirts you want to throw out there, because this is what's going to get you on the first tier up. So you're kind of picky when it comes to that stuff and rotating them in and out, but. Man, over 170 shirts right now is pretty awesome. That's, and you said about $200 to $300 per month, more or less, right?
Yeah, per month. I'm hoping that number is going to get higher next month as I obviously create more shirts. But yeah, it's been about $200 to $300 for the last couple of months now.
Nice, and I think one of the things that I talked about on the on my YouTube channel is just saying that, you know, whether you're making $50, $100, you know, you're starting off with something, and as it grows, you just get more excited about merch and how much more you like it, of course. But if you're at $200, $300, $400 or $500 per month, I mean, it's just amazing, because this didn't exist, you know, last year, like earlier last year. You could have just been talking about FBA uh-huh. and eBay and all this stuff, and then merch by Amazon just kind of came out of nowhere, and you're like, what, you know, what is this, and people getting into it. So to be making an extra $300 or $500 per month is insane, because this wasn't here last year.
Exactly, guys, that $200 to $300 a month, that's a car payment.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay? So, you know, I'm not putting up Glen Zubia type of numbers, but I'll tell you what, like I said, I got a late start, but again, that is a car payment for me. I'm currently happy with my progress and my whole growing of the business. Again, it's just a matter of time. Just got to put in the time and do the designs. And if you can't do the designs, take lessons. If you can't take lessons, hire a designer.
Yeah. I mean, there's so many ways to get shirts out there. And like what you said, it was a car payment. When, you know, after I got out of school, my like student loan was like $250 a month. You know, that's a student loan payment right there. That's, you know, to catch up as far as like getting bills paid or doing like things like that, just from selling shirts, I just think is awesome right now. A little bit. So right now I'm selling about 25 to 30 shirts a day. My numbers, I try to do on my YouTube channel, Hustler Hacks, I try to do, you know, one video a month just talking about my numbers. Usually I do it when it's around the payout day. The last 2 months I've made a little bit over $6,000 each. And then this last coming month, when I think I was in June is what the payout is this time, I made a little bit over $5,500. So it did go down a little bit. And I talked about it on my channel. That's when we went out of town for Austin. So I actually didn't list anything for an entire month. So if anybody tells you that passive income does not exist, this is the closest thing to it.
You know, and I'm glad you said that, because, you know, up until I got into merch, I firmly never believed in the whole 4-hour work week and the whole income. But like you said, I think this is probably the closest thing to it. And it's just, I mean, the opportunity is endless, because I'm not, again, you know, we don't have any inside scoop with Amazon. Okay. I mean, obviously we're just talking to you guys, you know, from my own personal experience with merch. But you know, it's guaranteed. I can almost promise you that they're going to have more than t-shirts. They're going to have other opportunities, hoodies,
exactly.
Tank tops. I don't know. What else is there?
Mugs,
mouse pads, mugs. Yeah. Tote bags. It's just a matter of time. I mean, is it going to be anytime soon? Again, I don't know. I don't work with Amazon, but I can almost guarantee it.
Oh yeah, for sure. And that's what we kind of want to cover here too, is that, you know, what me and Yong talked about with merch, and what I like about it is that, you know, we're on the grind just like you guys are. Even though I'm tiered up to 8,000, I think there's just so much more that I can learn from other people that are out there, you know, selling shirts on merch. And we want to have, you know, Q&A and special guests down the road. You know, this is the very first episode, but that's what we're looking on doing, because I just think there's so much we can learn from each other. And that's like the biggest thing that we also want to get from this is, you know, learning more, taking action, motivating each other to just, you know, make more money and do the best that we can on this platform.
Yeah, absolutely. And I don't know about you, but have you noticed that your illustrator skills have just gotten better? because it's like, you know, because it's funny, because I'm putting out designs every day now, and as I'm doing that, I'm finding that I'm being more efficient with Illustrator.
Yeah, I think you just get faster too.
Yeah, you get faster and you get better, because in the past, you know, I would go in there maybe once a week, twice a month. Now I'm doing it every day, and I'm getting better and I'm getting faster, and it's just like I said, I can typically, you know, have a design ready within 30 minutes.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah, it's just, you know, so yeah, absolutely. I mean if you guys are not trained in Illustrator or you know, I know a lot of you guys use Photoshop, just get on there every day and just start coming up with designs, and I promise you will get better and faster.
And do you use any of like the keyboard shortcuts when you do any of your designs?
I do.
Okay.
I don't know all of them, but I definitely do the whole keyboard shortcuts. And then for those of you guys that don't know them, again, I don't know all of them. I'm sure you can just go on YouTube and just do a search for Illustrator or Photoshop keyboard shortcuts.
Yeah, and in the future, we want to talk a little bit more about shortcuts, and Illustrator versus Photoshop, you know, what is better? What's easier for, you know, to use when it comes to merch stuff? A lot of the graphic design techniques that I think I've learned, not only through school, but also creating designs, logos, and flyers for, you know, for people being a freelance designer. I want to share a lot of these techniques that I think will help when it comes to, you know, creating some designs for merch. We have a lot of things that, you know, like I said, it's the very first episode, which we're pretty pumped about it. But what else, you know, can I say that we want to do, the things we want to cover? I mean, anything from copycats and trademark issues. I mean, there's just so much here on merch that we can cover. So definitely a lot of stuff to get to when it comes to that stuff.
Yeah, and we encourage the listeners. I mean, if there's a topic that you guys want us to go over, you know, feel free to reach out to us and let us know. Again, I mean, we might not be an expert in that particular area, but if we feel like it's a good topic, we can definitely go find someone and we can interview them as well. But yeah, I mean, you know, we're looking forward to other episodes where we cover a wide range of topics as far as merch and the whole print-on-demand industry.
Oh yeah, exactly. And I think special guests will be, you know, super important down the road. And because I like to see where everybody, you know, what worked for them and where are they and what are their goals? Because everybody is different. Everybody has different goals on what they want to do, how much money they want to make, how much time and effort are they putting into it. And you talked about it before that, you know, you're trying to knock out a certain amount per day. And, you know, I'm working with my family business and also juggling the YouTube channel, FBA and eBay, you know, a lot of things in our lives that we're trying to do. And that's not even including, you know, people with, like, let's say being married or having families or going, you know, everybody, like I said, is in different situations, but it's just so interesting to hear everybody's not only perspective on merch, but what their goals are.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, they all come from a different background. You know, they don't have the design background like we do, so it's, you know, it's like you said, it's always really interesting to see how they go about doing, you know, go about creating designs for the whole merch business. So yeah, absolutely.
And I tell people, you know, people contact me all the time, which you can contact me too, hustlerhacks1@gmail.com. But they ask me, you know, questions about merch or how much, you know, do I charge to do designs, which I do that too. But I even though I am charging for designs, I let them know, take a look on YouTube for tutorials, learn Illustrator, Photoshop, anything that can help you, because down the road, it can only help you to learn more things, to learn more platforms and programs. It's only going to help you more and more. And you can see that, you know, simple things here and there on Illustrator, you can crank out a couple of designs, and Adobe's even making it a lot easier now with their cloud servers, like $20 a month or something like that. You know, back in the day, a very expensive program if you're going to buy it all at once, you know, when it came to like the whole creative suite. Yeah. So they're even making it easier per month if that's something you want to do. But, you know, just so much opportunity out there, and we really want to cover every aspect that we can for Merch by Amazon.
Yeah, and you know, and Adobe, you know, I've said this before, they have free tutorials on their website. All you have to do is just do a Google search for Adobe Illustrator or Adobe Photoshop, and I think, you know, the results are going to be there in the top feed somewhere, but. Yeah, they give you free lessons on how to use their software. So why not take advantage and you know, I mean, you're learning from the horse's mouth. These are people that created the actual software. So go ahead and take the time to learn from them. But yeah, I mean, we're gonna try and cover every aspect of the whole business, man. I mean, like I said, if you guys, you know, if there's topics you want us to cover, let us know. I mean, again, this being the very first podcast, we just wanted to really share our journey into the whole Merch by Amazon business. And again, I know Glen is crushing it, but he's a huge inspiration to me, man, because I, you know, I see your numbers and I'm like, I know I can do that too. I know I can replicate exactly what Glen's doing. And again, it's just a matter of time before I catch up.
And if you have one shirt right now for sale, then I got to give it to you because you've already taken action by uploading one design. You know, you don't know how many people out there that have accounts that haven't uploaded any designs. And there's so many people that have contacted me. They're hungry out there, Yong. They're hungry because they want to get in. And yet there's some people in that don't have any shirts.
I'm hungry because I haven't had lunch yet, but okay, I totally get it. But yeah, no, but we've, you know, and we talked about this in the past as well, right? I mean, well, from what I've heard, merch is now rapidly starting to approve people. But even if you're not, start designing shirts now. Get them, start designing them now. So by the time you do get approved, all you have to do is just upload them. Okay, you don't have to waste the time to come up with a concept and all that when once you get approved. Once you do it now, all you have to do is just click upload. So start designing now.
Yeah, already having, it's pretty much getting the ball rolling right off the bat. I mean, you're not even, once you get accepted, already uploading 25 designs, you're already ready to go.
Yeah, because when I was at 25, I still kept designing. I still kept designing because I was like, well, once I get to 100, I'm just going to upload these right away. And that's what happened, right? I got tiered to 100. I started uploading my shirts because they were already designed. And you know, I couldn't upload any more shirts anymore because I ran out of slots.
Yeah, that's a good point that you mentioned. Just kept designing because if you stop, you might just get caught or something. Be like, yeah, you know what? I'll get back to it right now. I'll work on to it. I'll work on it later. And you don't want to get into that mode. If you're used to cranking out a certain amount of designs, then you can just, you know, beat yourself, really. One design, two designs, three designs per day. And you just keep cranking these out. I mean, once you tier up, you're just going to be ready to go. So you just keep tiering up, adding more designs. It's just going to get better and better.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So design shirts now. But Glen, so I want to go back to what you were saying. So you got tiered to 8,000.
Yes.
Is your goal to have 8,000 shirts eventually? or I mean, what's going on with that?
Well, according to their, I don't know, frequently asked questions or maybe a little bit more on their like settings and everything, they said that there's like a pro level or maybe like a infinity level. I don't know what it takes to get to that level. That's the level that I want to get to. Wow. I don't know how long it would get to that point because 8,000 is a lot to fill up. I mean, like I said, I have 2,500 right now. And with juggling all these projects, everything that I want to get done, I know it is going to take me a while to get to that point. But I don't know. That's something that I'm gonna try to figure out what I can do to get that 8,000 filled.
Okay. Yeah, because I'm, like I said, I'm at 500 and it's – it's taken me a while to come up with the designs. And again, I mean, you know, last week I mentioned this earlier, you know, I spent a whole day coming up with 60 designs, but still, I mean, it's even 500 is taking me a long time.
Oh yeah. And my brother's also doing merch by Amazon. And we talked when Yong was here in town, all three of us. Mm-hmm. And even when we went to Austin, we were talking about merch by Amazon too. And he's also tiered up to 500. So maybe like a special guest down the road, my brother can be on the show and talk about his, you know, everything that he's doing with merch by Amazon. Cause he's actually doing it a different way. I'm doing the whole numbers game. I'm trying to get as many shirts listed as possible, and he started off by kind of like building a brand, you know, has a logo for it,
yeah,
Facebook page, kind of promoting it and marketing it. And then he kind of started seeing that I kind of started telling him more and more, you know, the numbers game, and he saw what you were doing as far as like trending things. And so he was kind of like, you know what, maybe I need to change this up a little bit. So yeah, it'd be pretty interesting to hear his story on that.
Yeah. I mean, everyone has a different approach to it. But yeah, no, that's actually smart though, to have his own brand. I personally wouldn't do that until I have room to play with. I mean, if you're just getting started on merch, I would highly recommend that you create designs based on things that are trending, because you want to get sales fast and get tiered to the next level. And then once you have room to play with, I would start doing something like what Anthony is doing, and Anthony is Glenn's brother. But that's just my own opinion, though. But that's smart, though. I mean, to have his own brand as well. But yeah, I mean, everyone has a different approach. I mean, Glenn obviously said he's all about quantity right now. Mm-hmm. I was making shirts on current events and things that were trending, but I'm no longer doing that as much because, again, I want to create shirts that I can sell next year or 5 years from now.
Exactly. And the journey is like what's so interesting to me and the way people approach it. And like me and Yong said before, contact us. If you want to email me right now just so I can get some type of info, you want to be on the show, maybe something we can talk about, hustlerhacks1@gmail.com. We can talk about that a little bit more as far as like what you've done with merch. And I really want to hear from somebody that didn't know Illustrator but now knows a little bit about it. Like, I think that's really interesting to me. Someone learning the program through tutorials or maybe messing around with it and just learning more and more. I think that's really, really awesome. And I definitely want to hear from somebody like that.
Yeah, and you guys can contact me as well on Facebook and my email. And my email is hybridstyle, hybrid, just like the hybrid car, and then style@gmail.com. It's a long story how I got that email. Okay, so don't make me explain it.
That's for another episode.
That's for another episode, exactly. But yeah, you guys can contact me as well, either by email or on Facebook. But yeah, I mean, we love to hear from people. I've been somewhat coaching someone on the side with the whole Merch by Amazon business. He's making an effort to learn Illustrator, and he showed me some of his designs, and they're actually, for someone who's never done Illustrator, I have to say they're some of his designs were pretty clean.
Well, you're taking them under your wing, so
yeah.
What can I say, Yong? Just kidding. All right, so for the next couple of episodes, definitely look out for that. We really want to try to promote it more and more so we can get the word out there on the podcast. And, definitely have something for you to listen to when you're listing, creating shirts, in the car, something that you can just have merch on your mind 24/7.
Yeah. So, guys, speaking on that, again, this is the very first podcast, obviously. We would love some feedback. Let us know how we're doing. Let us know what we can do to make the podcast better. How's the audio? Any feedback is welcome. And I think Glenn and I, we had originally said that in the beginning, we're going to try and do these podcasts every other week. Again, because we don't have any feedback. This is our very first episode. So let us know how we're doing. And once we start hearing back from people, if you guys want, we'll start doing these every week. But for now, until we hear from you guys, we'll do it every other week.
Yeah, and we'll just keep going from there, growing the podcast and doing everything we can to spread the word of merch and help everybody out, learn from each other, and so on.
Yeah, and now this will be on iTunes. This will be on Glenn's website, I believe, at some point.
Yes, sir.
I currently am working on my own website. It's going to take some time, again, because with me juggling other projects, I can only commit to the website maybe at the most an hour a day. So at some point in the near future, I'm hoping to have something up, and the podcast will be on there as well. I think you're going to put the podcast on your YouTube channel as well. I'll do that as well. Okay. So that way you guys can have something to listen to. Like Glenn said, as you guys are designing or doing other things.
Exactly. All right. So I guess that's it, Yong, for the very first episode. Pretty awesome. A nice little introduction and talking a little bit about what we've done, what to expect on the podcast, a little bit about our numbers and tier ups, and of course, for the future of Merch by Amazon. So my name is Glenn with the YouTube channel Hustler Hacks. You can contact me or go to my website, hustlerhacks.com. And you are Yong. Let me know.
Yes, my name is Yong. You can contact me at, again, hybridstyle@gmail.com. Don't have the, I do have a domain for my website. Not going to give it out just yet. But again, guys, that will come in the near future. Thanks for listening.
In progress.
That's right. Thanks for listening. And we love to hear from you guys. Thanks again, guys.
See ya.